So now we will talk about like why a stick which is immersed in water partially, it appears to be bent from the surface. So what we are going to talk about now, actually we are going to discuss now the effects of refraction, like why there are few things which appear, which we know it appears like this, but then we do not know the reason, like how and why does it look like this, right? As just now I have given one example of lemon also. Like we all are quite familiar with this. Like whenever the lemon is kept in a glass jar filled with water, and when we observe it from the sides, it appears little bigger. We all know that. So now, like what we are going to talk about is only one example I'll take, because see again I am saying in 8th standard there is no need to go. Like just we'll be touching this all the sub points, sub topics, right? So detailing will be done in the 10th standard, but still. As a ace and student, we should know this, like what it is. So now, for now, we'll be discussing a few, one example I'll talk about, like why does it appears. So what now we are going to talk about, a stick. It is actually refraction, and in refraction we are going to talk about like why a stick immersed partially in water appears to be bent from the surface, right? So why does it happen? Now suppose here we have got the water surface, right? This is the area which is filled with water, I'm not drawing much water now, I'll be drawing afterwards, so that first of all what we want to draw, what we want to understand, that we should be able to understand, see clearly, right? So now suppose one stick, right, this is one stick which is here, right? A stick is kept obliquely into the water body. Now this is the stick, and I can name this stick as A, this point is B, and this point is O, right? Now when we see a stick which is immersed in water, and this is immersed partially, why partially? Because this portion is above only, this portion is not into water, this is not immersed, rather this is immersed in water, right? So why does it appears to be bent? Why does it appears to be bent? So now what happens actually from the point O, right? From the point O, a ray comes out, right? A ray comes out, and we can name it as, right? And we can name it as C, right? And this after refraction, see now, try to understand, here we have got water, and here we have got air. Now we know air is a rarer medium, and water is a denser medium. We are comparing each other only, like these two only among, within themselves. So air is rare medium as compared to the water, and water is a denser medium as compared to the air. So now a ray of light which comes from here, from this point, from this bottom O of the stick. Now this get, as the medium is getting changed, so definitely a refraction, refraction will take place. And refraction, like which kind of refraction will take place, like what will happen? It will move towards or away from the normal, from denser medium to the rarer medium. So definitely it will move away from the normal. So now it moves away from the normal. I'll just one O here, and right, so it get like this. After refraction it is coming like this, I can name it as X. And one more ray coming from here, right? And this I can name it as D, and it also get refracted, and I can name it as Y. Now, when the person see observe from here, right? When the person observe from here, now what is happening? You know, this. If we, you know, we try to extend this at the back side backward, so we get a point over here. Right, so we get a point over here, and this is point, I should say, like I. Right, so now when these rays, if we move it backwards, we get a point which is known as I. Now, what is I? I is the image. Okay, point I is the image of point O. Right, it is the image of this point O, and which kind of image it is? It is virtual image, isn't it? It is a virtual image, because the rays are not meeting actually over here, right? It just appears to meet over here, intersect over here. Now, this is the image of only one single point. If we try to draw perpendicular from here, or try to, you know, join all the points, then we'll get one more, you know, like this kind of structure we'll get, right? And this can be known as BI. This can be known as BI. Now, what is BI? BI is the image of the stick of which part? Only this part BO. So, it is the image of the BO. Right. So, what actually is happening now? Here we have got one, like here we have got the, you know, point image of the this point O. Now, if we extend it, we will get the whole, like, you know, complete image of this stick. Now, actually this is the virtual image of this stick which is bent, which is not actually bent, which is immersed in the water, right? So now when the person see from there, now this stick is not bent, okay? This stick is not bent, this is filled with water. Now I can draw water over here, right? So this area is filled with water. Now what is happening when this AB, it is outside only, this AB is outside only and BO is inside, right? Now when we talk about the rays, always we know, like we have discussed only, you know, we discuss only about two rays. So when we talk about the ray come out from here and it moves out at OC, it get refracted as CX, right? OC, and then it get refracted as CX. Now again the second ray OD, which after refraction move out as DY. Now when the person see from here, the point I is observed here, this one is the point I, is what? It is the virtual image of only the point O. Now if we extend it to all different points, then what will happen? We get the BI, this which is the virtual image of this stick, this part of the stick BO. So when the person see from here, it appears that the stick is bent, right? Stick is bent, and this point is considered, you know, is seen, observed as the bottom point, lower point, and this is a virtual image which is being formed. And actually here this AB and BI, these are not in straight line. Are you getting my point? This two are not in straight point, because this is virtual, it is formed little bit, you know, towards the higher side. So this two are not in straight line, and so it appears that this stick is bent, right? So this is how, you know, now you can understand all the different examples, like when the coin is put inside the water, then what and how it will look. Again, the lemon example, then why the swimming pool appears to be little, you know, less deeper, and all these examples. So all these examples will go like this only, like, you know, the image, the virtual image is formed over here, and after refraction what is happening here, when the medium is getting changed, this is the denser medium, this is rare medium. So after refraction, you know, what will happen? The ray will move away from the normal. And that is the reason after refraction, when the person see from here, observe from here, a virtual image is observed here, you know, and that is the reason this stick appears to be bent, right? So this is how all the reasons can be understood and all the examples can be understood. Now we'll talk about the lenses. So, you know, what are the lenses, like how many kind of lenses are there? And then again we will talk not in detail, but just we'll have a look what are the different, you know, rules again for the, you know, image formation. We'll see images also in both the kinds of glass, this lenses like convex also and concave also, right? So please note this. Now we'll talk about lenses. So now we'll talk about the refraction, but refraction of the spherical lenses, right? So just let me write the heading: refraction of light by spherical surface or lenses, right? So what we are going to talk about now, we will be discussing about the refraction, okay, refraction of light by spherical lenses, right? Refraction of light by the spherical lenses. Now, you know, actually when we talk about the lenses, children, we all have seen lenses. We all have seen lenses. Now, where we have seen these lenses, you know, like when we talk about the magnifying glass, right? Magnifying glass is what? It is lens, right? Then even when you talk about your spectacles, right? You have spectacles. So in the spectacles also lenses are used. Apart from this microscope, telescopes, cameras. So in all these instruments, lenses are utilized, lenses are used. Now refraction, like when we talk about the glasses, when we are discussing about the glasses, that definitely we are talking about reflection. But when we talk about the lenses, then definitely it is refraction. We will be discussing about refraction. Now, you know, in glasses also we studied many points, isn't it? Like focus, principal axis, center of curvature. Similarly, in the spherical lenses also we need to understand certain terminologies. And before doing that, we need to talk about, we need to learn, we need to discuss the definition, we need to define the this particular lens. So how can we define lens, children? It is a piece of, okay, it is a piece of transparent, okay, it is a piece of transparent glass bound by two spherical surfaces, right? So what actually lens is, children? Lens is a transparent, okay, mirrors are polished from one side, but the lenses are not at all polished from any of the side. They are totally just a piece of glass. So it is a piece of transparent glass and which is bounded by two spherical surfaces. So now this will understand like how it is bounded by two spherical surfaces. So a lens is a piece of transparent glass which is bounded by two spherical surfaces. Actually, children, now we directly will talk about two kind of lenses in which we'll be discussing about two different spherical surfaces also. So there are two different, you know, lens: convex lens and concave lens. Right? Convex and concave. Now, convex lens are like this. Right, this is convex lens and this part is bulgy part, and this bulgy part is known as convex side, isn't it? This is convex side and this is also convex side. So it is bounded by two spherical surfaces. Now when we talk about the concave lens, it will be like this. So this part is also concave and this part is also concave. You know, actually, children, what lenses are, they, we consider it as like this is also the part of a sphere, right? And this is also part of a sphere. So there are two spheres, which is, you know, and we are like this this lens that is the reason we are saying like it is bounded by two spherical surfaces. These are actually two spheres which is responsible for the formation of the lens, or we can say this it is a part of the sphere. These both are part of different sphere, isn't it? Here also it will be the same thing. Now you know, when we take the lens in a hand, right, when we take the lenses in a hand, okay, one the convex lens and the concave lens, while taking also, while keeping these lenses in our hand also, we will be able to understand, we will be able to distinguish the difference between the two. How will be able to understand the difference between the two, children? This convex lens is thicker from the middle, isn't it? It's thicker from the middle, thicker from the center part, right? It is thicker from the center and pointing from the corners. And when you take the concave lens in your hand, you will understand like there is depression in the center, okay? The center part is very very thin, isn't it? This part has depression. Now depression means what? It is very thin from here, right? It is very thin from here, rather it is thicker from the upper part. It is thicker from the upper part. So this way there are two kind of lenses, the convex lens and the concave lens. Now convex lens, it is made up of two bulgy part is there. This outer part is bulgy, right? And like this one is also convex, this one is also convex. So when you take this in hand, you will understand like then the center part is thicker, whereas the opposite, this part's poles are very very thin. Now when you talk about the concave lens, children, you will understand like in the center there is depression, whereas the corners are thicker. So this is the main difference between the concave and the convex and the concave lens. Now apart from this, one more part, thing is there, like convex lenses are converging in nature, right? Convex lenses are converging in nature. Converging, if you remember, we have discussed converging means what? To bring, to get collected one point, to bring together, collecting. And concave lenses are diverging lenses. This is scattering out, isn't it? Scatter out. So convex lenses are converging lenses, right? And the concave lenses are diverging lenses. Now we will talk about certain important terms which we need to understand when we talk about the lenses. So first of all, we need to talk about the optical center. Optical center is what, children? Optical center is the center, okay? It is a center of the lens. It is a center point of the lens. So optical center is what, children? Optical center is the center part of any lens. So what is optical center? Optical center is a center part of the lens. It can be denoted by, it is denoted by C. It is denoted by C, and it can also be denoted by O, right? So it is the center point of any lens, and in both the cases, in the convex lens also and in the concave lens also, it is a center point. The middle part, the middle point of the lens is known as optical center. It is denoted by C and it can also be denoted by O. Now very important thing, children, that whenever a ray of light passes through it, okay, when a ray of light passes through it, it goes straight, passes through it, it goes straight without deviation, right? Without deviation. Right, when a ray of light passes like this from this point, this is a center point. When the ray of light passes from this point, so it will go just straight only, okay, from this point. I'm talking about this point, optical center. or which like optical center which can be denoted by C or O. So when the ray of light passes from this optical center, do not deviate. It do not, neither it will go this side, that side, neither nose, it won't go anywhere, you know. I get simmer sometimes. It won't go anywhere, rather it will go very straight, it will pass straight to the, now. So this is the first point, first thing which we have understood, optical center, this is the middle, the center part of the lens. Now we'll talk about the principal axis. Now, what is the meaning of principal axis, children? The straight line which passes through the optical center. Isn't it the straight line which passes through the, here also, the straight line which passes, the straight line which passes through the optical center is known as principal axis, right? So the principal axis of a lens is a line passing through, a line passing through the optical center. Of the lens which is perpendicular to both the faces of the lens, right? So now we have, you know, I have wrapped this so that I know I can draw the next diagram and we can understand the next things. So for here, just now we have discussed the optical center, children. Right, so this center part, okay, this center part is known as optical center, which can be denoted by C or O. Right, after this I have written the definition of principal axis of a lens. Okay, principal axis of a lens is a line passing through the optical center. So this is the line passing through this optical center. Definitely this is the line which is passing through the optical center. It can be denoted as XY and this is known as the principal axis, right? So, and it is perpendicular to both the lenses, both the surfaces it is perpendicular. Now the next which I want to write here is focus. Okay, now we are talking here about convex lens, children, right? Now convex lens, as we have discussed, you know, it is a converging lens, isn't it? It is a converging lens, right? Convex lens is a converging lens. So what will happen? We have discussed now this thing n number of times and this should be now self understood, like when the ray of light which, you know, is parallel to the principal axis, after, you know, it has to pass from the focus. That is, you know, it depends upon which kind of lens it is, whether it will be passing in real, you know, really it will pass or it will pass virtually. So in convex lens, you know, when we talk about convex lens, these are the, you know, rays, okay. This is a ray, say suppose AB. Now this is a parallel ray which is passing through the lens and after refraction it meet at one point, right? Again another ray and it meet at one point. Again another ray, it meet at one point. That means that is the reason it is known as converging lens. Why it is known as converging lens? Because the ray of light which are scattered, which are coming from the different places, it all come and it converge at one place after refraction. So this is the meaning of what, focus. This point is known as focus and this is known as convergence in convex mirror lens. Again, it happens many a times like mirror and lenses. So here we are talking about convex lens and this point is known as focus, right? This point is known as focus. Why it is known as focus? Because these rays are parallel to principal axis. I can draw this principal axis with some other color so that one can understand, like this is a principal axis, right? This is a principal axis which is passing through the optical center. Now the other rays, which are parallel to the principal axis, when it passes through the lens after refraction, it get converged at one point, which is known as focus. So how can we define focus, children? Now we can define focus by saying, it is focus is a point, okay, on the principal axis. It is the point on the principal axis to which all parallel light rays converge after a refraction. Okay, now when we talk about focus, it is very, very important, like it has to be mentioned, like this focus I'm talking about, with like whose focus it is, focus of the convex lens. So no, it is very essential in one all only L right here we are talking about convex lens, because if we talk about concave mirror, again the definition will change. So focus is what? It is a point where, you know, when we talk about the different rays which are parallel to the principal axis, it passes from the lens and after refraction it get converged at one point. So this is known as what? Focus. Now when we talk about the lenses, children, in lens also we need to discuss about focal length. Okay, as we have discussed in mirror also. So what is the focal length, children? It is a distance between. It is the distance between the focus optical center and the focus, right? So what is focal length, children? Focal length is this. Okay, say this is our C, this is our F. So this distance, the distance between, okay, the distance between what? The distance between the C and F, or the optical center, the distance between the optical center and focus is known as what? The focal length. Now, you know, apart from these, there are certain more points to understand in lens. Now, as we have discussed that lens is made up of two spherical, two spherical surfaces are there. So definitely when the rays of light are coming from the left hand side, right here in this diagram, these rays are coming from the left hand side, and so they are getting converged on the, this side, right hand side. But as I said, like it has got two spherical surfaces. So when the rays of light will pass through this side, so definitely it is going to get converged somewhere at this point. So, as this had got two spherical, I have drawn this diagram before this, rubbing over here. So it has got two focus, children, right? So this is F focus and this is F dash. Now these both the focuses are at equal distance, right? They are at equal distance from the optical center. Are you getting my point? The lenses have two focus, right? Two focus are there, and these are at equal distance, okay? These are at equal distance from the optical center, right? So this is C, this is optical center, and this is F, first focus. So it can be represented by F dash, so it will be the second focus. Now the double of focus, right, the double of focus can be 2F. So what is 2F? 2F is just double of focus. So these all are the points on a lens which needs to be understood. Now when I say like convex lens is a converging lens, so definitely the concave lens is a diverging lens. Now we'll see the diagram of the concave lens and we'll try to understand what are the positions, what all we need to know in the concave lens also. So here, first of all, we have discussed like what are the lenses. Lenses are the spherical surfaces, you know, they are the transparent glass surfaces, and it can be of two type, convex and concave. Convex are the converging lenses, and when we hold, you know, these two lenses separately, we will be able to understand like which one is convex and which one is concave. Why? Because the convex lens have the thicker part in the center and thinner at the edges, whereas when we talk about the concave lens, it is thinner from the, it has got depression in the center, while the two ends, right, while the two ends are the thicker one. So again, after this we have also discussed certain points on the lenses which we need to understand. So the center point of the lens is known as optical center, which can be represented by C or O. Then the line which passes through optical center, a perpendicular line, which is known as the principal axis. Now there are different points on the principal axis which we need to understand. When the rays, when the parallel rays will pass through the convex lens and it get converged after refraction at one particular point, that is known as F, principal focus. Now lenses will have two focus. One can be represented as F and the other can be represented by F dash. Now focal length is a distance between the optical center, the center point, and the focus. So this is a distance between the optical center and the focus. Now again, this side also, when you talk about the you know, this one F dash and F, so this are at the equal distance from the optical center. This distance between the C and F dash and C and F are the equal distances. Now if we double the distance of the F, that will be 2F, right, which is present on both the sides. So now this is all about the this is all in the sense the introductory part I have given. Now we'll talk about the concave lens a bit.